Rocket fans, I just want to give you a little update on a challenge I have given myself. So before we get to the details, I just want to put one number in your head. 7,920. We'll get back to that later. You see, I have received a few comments on the choice of design for the booster drogue parachute, and they make sense. So let me give a little more background on the decision. The first prototype I have decided to try out is the Supersonic X design, which more or less looks like a flying onion. There are many different designs that have been tested to be functional in the speed range we expect to see for the booster during descent. But the reason I chose the Supersonic X design for the first prototype is that it's very easy to make. It did not take me many evenings, relatively speaking, at the dining table to get the first prototype done, so it would be wonderful if we could confirm this to be a winning design. Another design, which almost all the grown-ups use, is the one I have been avoiding for quite a while, since it is exceptionally complex to make. It is called a ribbon parachute and comes in different shapes, most typically the conical and hemisphere design. The difference lies in the shape, where the conical is basically designed like a cone. That design is perfect for lower speed usage, like deployment, when you're well into the atmosphere again. Another design, the hemisphere, is shaped like a sphere, which is a design better suited for supersonic speeds, because it distributes the loads more evenly on the ribbons and gauze. The hemisphere is slightly more complicated to design, but my impression is that the production will be almost the same. So since I already had a core template for the uprighting bags for the space capsule, it was just a matter of modifying that template to include ribbons. On this note, I would like to say thank you to the parachute team at DARE, and especially Sayam Gurana, for giving me the last piece of inspiration I needed to make my design tool. On to the reason why I have stayed away from the ribbon parachute concept. Until now, the designs I've worked on have been pretty straightforward. Typically, they have consisted of 12 to 16 cores, sometimes split in two, a few add-ons, and then attach the lines. So that have been pretty easy so far, relatively speaking. The challenge with the ribbon parachute domain is that it requires a lot of pieces. Just to give you an idea, I have now started working on a small prototype, 1.24 meter diameter hemisphere ribbon parachute. In the prototype, I've decided to make 12 gores to speed things up a bit, in order to get the right amount of porosity, which is a term for how much air will let through. I have made a design with 27 ribbons on each, and you can see them here. 27 ribbons on each gore. For each gore, each ribbon has 3 attachment points. So even for this small prototype, that gives me 972 connection points to sew. And here comes the big clue as to why I am hesitant in going this way. Should we decide to go ahead and make a full-scale version, this number would increase to 2,640 connections per parachute, giving a total of 7,920 connections points, all of which would require at least 2 runovers with the sewing machine. So as you can tell, I'm trying to keep an open mind to this challenge, but I hope you can understand why I hope that we get some good data with the Supersonic X design, because otherwise, I don't know what to say. Thank you.
Copenhagen Suborbitals is a non-profit all-volunteer project. The reason we are getting so close to reaching space on our speaker rocket is because all of our crowdfunding supporters. If you've been following this project and feel passionate about new ways of exploring space and building rockets, you can help us out by going over to our website, www.copsub.com, and becoming a supporter with a small monthly or one-time donation that helps us pay workshop rent and buy materials. And in return, you get all these insider videos on building a space program, which you don't really get anywhere else. So on behalf of everybody at Copenhagen Suborbitals, thank you for your support, and we'll see you next time.